Namaskar, good evening. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi with News Tonight. Let's begin the bulletin with the top headlines. Prime Minister Narendra Modi addresses public rallies in three states. In Karnataka's Koppal district, Prime Minister charges Congress and JDS with being detached from people and attached to their own family. In Ahmednagar, Maharashtra urges voters to choose NDA's honest intentions over false promises made by the NCP Congress combined. BJP President Amit Shah calls Naxal attack that killed party MLA in Chhattisgarh a political conspiracy. Seeks CBI probe into it at campaign rally in Rajnandgaon. In Tamil Nadu, Congress Chief Rahul Gandhi makes a strong pitch for DMK Stalin as Chief Minister of the state. Supreme Court rules that electoral bonds will stay, asks all parties to furnish details of donors and their donations in a sealed cover by 30th May. Also directs Finance Ministry to reduce a window of bonds purchase from 10 days to 5 days in April-May period. Defence Ministry making efforts to ensure unutilized defence budget is not sent back. Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman says Finance Ministry has responded positively to a clear demand made by her ministry on the issue. Jet Airways extends suspension of its international operations till Monday. Prime Minister's office calls urgent meeting to review situation including rising airfares due to sharp decline in number of flights in the country. First, all the election news from the Lok Sabha elections 2019. Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Friday campaigned in Maharashtra, Karnataka and Kerala. Addressing the public in Karnataka's Koppal, the Prime Minister targeted the Congress, a JDS coalition in the state, over its alleged corruption and dynasty politics. He called the JDS-Congress alliance a 20% government, saying their only mission was commission. Prime Minister Narendra Modi also attacked the Congress party over the Rafael deal.
JDS-Congress aur inke mahamilavati dal hamare desh ki suraksha ko koi mahatva nahi dete. Yahi soch hai jiski wajah se inke हर रक्षा सौदे में कोई न कोई घोटाला होता रहा यही सोच है जिसकी वजह से हमारे जवानों को ये खराब क्वालिटी के हथियार मुहैया कराते हैं यही सोच है जिसकी वजह से हमारे वीरों को सीमा पर जरूरी सुविधाएं नहीं दी जाती यही सोच है
In Maharashtra's Ahmednagar, the Prime Minister said that the world is recognizing India as a superpower now and urged the voters to choose wisely between honest chowkidar and corrupt namdar.
Ek taraf hamare sankalp hai, wahi dusri taraf Congress NCP ke dhakosle hai. Ek taraf pani ke liye महायुति सरकार के काम है तो दूसरी तरफ कांग्रेस सरकार में हुए घोटाले और अजीत परिवार के शर्मनाक बयान है ऐसे ही अपराधों की वजह से देश के लोगों ने कांग्रेस का मन और कांग्रेस की नीयत को अच्छी तरह जान लिया है पहचान लिया है और इसलिए अब जनता ने ही नया नारा दे दिया है, कांग्रेस हमेशा के लिए हटाओ, कांग्रेस हमेशा के लिए हटाओ, तभी देश में गरीबी दूर होगी।
Meanwhile, in poll-bound Kerala, the Prime Minister targeted the LDF and UDF and said that both the parties have miserably failed the people of Kerala.
Friends, for decades, the communist LDF and communal UDF have dominated Kerala politics but they have miserably failed the people of Kerala.
And BJP President Amit Shah campaigned in Chhattisgarh and Odisha on Friday. In Chhattisgarh's Rajnandgaon, Shah described the recent Naxal attack in Dantewada, in which a BJP MLA was killed, as a political conspiracy and sought a CBI probe into it. Addressing the public, Shah said, "The Modi government's biggest success was that it had made India secure, which was not the case when the Congress-led UPA was in power."
आतंकवादी प्रवृत्ति करते थे, हमारे जवानों के सर काट कर ले जाते थे, अपमानित करते थे, कोई जवाब दिया नहीं। अभी अभी पुलवामा पर हमला हुआ और पुलवामा पर हमले में 40 जवान शहीद हो गए, 40 जवान शहीद। मगर इस बार मौनी बाबा मनमोहन सिंह की सरकार नहीं थी, नरेंद्र मोदी जी की सरकार थी, नरेंद्र मोदी। जवानों की शहीदगी के 13वीं के दिन मोदी जी ने एयरफोर्स को ऑर्डर दिया और हमारी एयरफोर्स पाकिस्तान के घर में घुसकर आतंकवादियों के अड्डों पर बम गिराकर पाकिस्तान के आतंकवादियों के टुकड़े टुकड़े कर वापिस आ गए।
इन ओडिशास के उंझार Shah targeted the Naveen Patnaik government and said that the state government is doing nothing for the development of the state.
ये विशाल अस्पताल भविष्य में जहां मेरी आदिवासी माताएं बहनें बुजुर्ग भाई सबका इलाज होने वाला है, ये नरेंद्र मोदी जी ने भेजे हुए डीएमएफ के पैसों से बन रहा है। मोदी जी तो भेज रहे हैं, परंतु नवीन बाबू ने अपने खिसे से एक 54 ने भी ये मेडिकल कॉलेज के लिए नहीं दी, एक 54 ने भी नहीं।
Congress President Rahul Gandhi on Friday addressed 4 public rallies in Tamil Nadu's Krishnagiri, Salem, Theni and Madurai. While addressing a rally in Salem, he said that the moment Congress comes to power, we will give people a real GST, one tax, minimum tax and simple tax. In Theni, Rahul Gandhi said, if we come to power, our next budget will be dedicated to the farmers. Meanwhile, speaking to the people in Krishnagiri, he reiterated that if voted to power, we guarantee to deposit 72,000 rupees annually to 20% poor Indian families under the Nyay scheme.
72,000 rupees every year, 3,60,000 rupees in 5 years. We will make a list of the 20% poorest people in India. And then after that, every one of these families will be given 72,000 rupees every year.
Trinamool Congress Supremo and West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee on Friday said that we will never seek votes highlighting soldiers' achievements. Addressing a rally in West Bengal's Kursiong City, we are proud of our armed forces, but I will never seek votes highlighting the achievements of soldiers. Asserting that regional parties will play a major role in the ongoing Lok Sabha elections, Banerjee said, we will together form the government at the centre. And BJP delegation on Friday moved Election Commission seeking action against Rahul Gandhi for his abusive and false comments against Prime Minister Narendra Modi. This move was made after Gandhi's remarks on Friday, I beg your pardon, on Wednesday, where he called Prime Minister Narendra Modi a thief. The delegation was led by Union Ministers Nirmala Sitaraman and Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi. The delegation also submitted a memorandum to the Election Commission accusing the Trinamool Congress of poll rigging in West Bengal. An Aam Aadmi Party and JJP have forged an alliance in Haryana for the Lok Sabha elections. Aam Aadmi Party leader Gopal Rai and JJP leader Dushyant Chautala announced this at a joint press conference in New Delhi on Friday. Under the alliance, Aam Aadmi Party will contest in 3 seats and JJP in 7 Lok Sabha seats in Haryana.
आम आदमी पार्टी और जेजेपी ने लोकसभा चुनाव के अंदर मिल करके हरियाणा के अंदर एक विकल्प देने का निर्णय लिया है। हरियाणा के अंदर आज कांग्रेस खंड खंड विखंडित है और ऐसे में आम आदमी पार्टी और जेजेपी का ये आपसी तालमेल और गठबंधन जो अभी तक भारतीय जनता पार्टी घूम रही है कि वो सारी सीटें जीत रही है, जिम्मेदारी के साथ कहना चाहता हूं कि हरियाणा का युवा उस बदलाव के मुहाने पर इस गठबंधन की मसाल को लेकर के आगे बढ़ेगा और इसे पूरा करेगा।
And some more election related developments. Former Union Minister Krishna Tirath on Friday rejoined the Congress after a gap of 4 years. Tirath, who was a Minister of State in the Manmohan Singh government, had joined the Bharatiya Janata Party in 2015. She contested the 2015 Delhi Assembly polls on BJP ticket but lost to the Aam Aadmi Party. She has been a 2-time MP from Delhi.
और पुराने घर में आने का मतलब कभी कभी कुछ चीज़ें ऐसी घट जाती हैं जिसको एक्सीडेंट कहते हैं। एक्सीडेंट हुआ और वापस आ गए तो उससे ज़्यादा क्योंकि मुझे अपने लोगों का, देश का और किस तरह से दलितों का, महिलाओं का, पीड़ितों का एक उद्धार करना है, तो जो पहले से एक क्षमता यहाँ है, इस पार्टी में है, उस क्षमता को और बढ़ाने के लिए मैं आई हूँ।
And withdrawal of candidature for the fourth phase of Lok Sabha polls ended on Friday. In this phase, polling will take place on 71 Lok Sabha constituencies across 9 states on 29th of April. Nominations for fourth phase began with the issue of notification on 2nd of April. Campaigning for this phase will end on 27th of April. Voting will be held in 17 seats in Maharashtra, 13 seats each in Rajasthan and Uttar Pradesh, 6 seats each in Madhya Pradesh and Odisha, 8 seats in West Bengal and 5 in Bihar, 3 in Jharkhand and 1 seat in Jammu and Kashmir. Even for Odisha Assembly, withdrawal of candidature for the fourth phase ended. Polling will also be held on 29th of April. And a 3-judge bench of the Supreme Court directed all political parties to submit the details of donations received through electoral bonds till 15th of May to the Election Commission by 30th May. The Apex Court said that it would examine in detail changes made in income tax law, electoral law and banking laws to make them in consonance with the electoral bond scheme and ensure balance does not tilt in favour of any political party. And with that, we'll slip into a very quick break. More news and updates on the other side. Stay with us.
Watch The Big Picture with me at 9:30 p.m. only on Rajya Sabha TV.
Trophy boat race of Kerala, popularly called Vallam Kali in local parlance. This historic boat race dates back to 1952 when Pandit Nehru visited the state and a pageantry of boats accompanied him from Kottayam to Alappuzha. The race conducted on the second Saturday of August every year is a major tourist attraction. It's generally the snake boats which participate in the race, and hence the shape of the winner's trophy is also a replica of a snake boat.
Welcome back. The government is working towards accelerating efforts to indigenize and accelerate defense production. As a step towards this, the Defense Ministry has asked the Finance Ministry to ensure that once a defense budget is allocated, the unutilized part does not go back to the Consolidated Fund of India. This will ensure that the fund can be used towards committed expenditure to procuring much needed equipment. More details in this report.
Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman on Friday said her ministry has made a clear demand to the Finance Ministry that once the defence budget is allocated, the unutilised part should not be sent back to the consolidated funds. She said in this way the long-term perspective plan of the Defence Ministry is becoming a rolling long-term perspective plan.
We've made a clear demand to the finance that once allocated, it shall not go back, and the committed expenditure, whichever year that may happen, will happen from this fund, which probably will get accumulated, whichever way they would look and define it. It shall keep accumulating, and the moment that it was budgeted for, which didn't happen in year X, but happens in X plus fifth year, the money is there for you. So we have made sure that this negotiation with finance is happening, and I can confidently say that there is a positive response from the finance.
The Defence Minister also released reports on the Indigenous Research and Development and Cyber Security prepared by think tank Vivekanand International Foundation in New Delhi.
Underlying point that we are placing before these organisations, whether they're producing missiles or aircrafts or helicopters, there is a market outside. A lot of countries are keen to have some kind of engagement with India, and with all things taken care of, due diligence complied with, they want to purchase from you. India has immense potential to be an exporter of defense equipment, whether it's aircraft, whether it's... And I can also say, even a shipbuilding, warship building capability is very well recognized outside.
The report emphasizes the urgent need to accelerate indigenization of defense production. It says growing dependence on imported defense equipment not only burdens financial resources, but also adversely impacts national security. With inputs from Panchanan Mishra, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And news now from the Jet Airways crisis. The PMO on Friday held an urgent meeting with the DGCA and the Civil Aviation Secretary to discuss the crisis in private airline Jet, which is facing acute financial woes. It was decided in the meeting that the Jet will fly 6 to 7 aircraft on both days this weekend on domestic routes. The airline has been told to alert passengers about flight cancellations 48 hours in advance and to take passenger issues into consideration. Jet Airways representatives also met with the bankers and put forth a demand for funds. The development comes hours after the Jet Airways extended the suspension of its international operations till next Monday due to severe liquidity issues. Cash-strapped Jet Airways has grounded several of its flights and is operating less than 50 domestic flights per day. And taking note of the alleged harassment of custom officials at Kolkata airport for checking the luggage of wife of a Trinamool Congress leader, the Supreme Court on Friday issued notice to the state government on the matter. Headed by Chief Justice Ranjan Gogoi, an apex court bench also termed the alleged incident very, very serious. It did not consider the submission of senior advocate A.M. Singhvi that no notice was required to be issued on the petition. On 29th of March, the centre had told the Apex Court that custom officials at Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose International Airport in Kolkata were intimidated, harassed and threatened by the local police for checking the baggage of the wife of the TMC MP, who is a relative of the Chief Minister, Mamata Banerjee. It also alleged that institutional anarchy and complete lawlessness have been prevailing in West Bengal. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu released a commemorative postage stamp and a coffee table book to mark the 125th Foundation Day of the Punjab National Bank today. He also felicitated the great-grandchildren of Lala Lajpat Rai, who was one of the most prominent leaders of India's struggle for independence and one of the founders of the bank. Addressing the event, Vice President said that banks must adhere strictly to the principles of business ethics and good corporate governance. He also stressed that banks can make use of technology and data analytics to recognize early warning signs of loan defaulting and evolve robust mechanisms to identify hidden NPAs. He also said that India must enter into more intelligence exchange treaties on financial fraud and bank accounts and work with international agencies.
Increasing cases of willful defaults and frauds have recently been in the news. Few black ships brought bad name to the system. I've been going around different countries. I've been to various forums. I have been strongly advocating that all the countries must have treaties to exchange information with regard to bank accounts wherever necessary, wanted by the government or the agencies. Second, we must also have extradition treaties. Otherwise, you just loot here and then go and then stay there and then a lot of legal process. This is a time-taking process and people are becoming impatient. If you are a civilized world, the world must put this question to themselves, are we civilized? Then how are you allowing tax havens? How are you encouraging black money? This is a question to be put to every nation, to themselves. And if you are civilized, if you are really democratic, you must all come together and have extradition treaties wherever somebody is wanted. They should be extradited at the earliest. This is the need of the hour.
April 13th, 2019 will mark 100 years of the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu will pay homage to the martyrs of Jallianwala Bagh massacre on the centenary of the gruesome incident at the Jallianwala Bagh Memorial in Amritsar, Punjab on Saturday. Naidu will release a commemorative coin and commemorative postage stamp. The event is marked to observe the centenary of the massacre in which hundreds of innocent men, women and children were killed by Brigadier General Dyer during a peaceful meeting at the park on 13th April 1919. It was declared a national memorial by an Act of Parliament titled Jallianwala Bagh National Memorial Act 1951. It is managed by the Jallianwala Bagh National Memorial Trust. Meanwhile, hundreds of people, including students, local residents and even visitors, held a candlelight march in Amritsar on the eve of 100th anniversary of Jallianwala Bagh massacre by British Indian forces. Punjab Governor V.P. Singh Badnore and Punjab Chief Minister Amrinder Singh joined the candlelight march. According to the Russian embassy, Prime Minister Narendra Modi was on Thursday named for the Order of St. Andrew the Apostle award by Russia for exceptional services in promoting bilateral ties between the two countries. The Order of St. Andrew the Apostle is the highest state decoration of Russia. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has been conferred with the award for exceptional services in promoting special and privileged strategic partnership between Russia and India. Meanwhile, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that he is honored to receive this prestigious award. He thanked President Vladimir Putin and the people of Russia. He said that foundations of India-Russia friendship are deep and the future of our partnership is bright. and extensive cooperation between both the nations has led to extraordinary outcomes for the citizens. And that's all we have for you in this edition of News Tonight. Thank you for watching. Namaskar.